Hello, good evening. Welcome to Decision Time. This is Pastor Richard from Ark Mission House of Prayer, Leeds. I'm so grateful and glad that you're tuning. Praise the Lord. Once again, tell friends, family, members, and work colleagues, praise the Lord, that Decision Time is right here. Praise the Lord. Also, if you don't have a place of worship, if you don't have a place where you serve God, if you don't have a place where you fellowship with other believers, because this is very vital. The warfare that we engage in is a collective warfare, because the Bible says that we are not fighting against flesh and blood. It did not say, I, praise the Lord. It's a collective warfare, praise the Lord. So it's something we do together. You cannot isolate yourself, praise the Lord. You need to join other believers in order to engage with the enemy, praise the Lord. And if I'm to tell you something, I've seen some of these principalities and powers, praise the Lord. They always move in a company. I was so surprised. Praise the Lord. They move what? In a company. They don't move in one. Praise the Lord. Because they know the importance of strategic unity. Did you hear that? They know the importance of what? Strategic unity. They position themselves in different places so that they can easily come to help or aid one another. Praise the Lord. So, please, if you don't have a home church and you are in Leeds area, specifically West Yorkshire, maybe you are in Bradford, maybe you are in Huddersfield, Wakefield, Leeds, even if you are somewhere in North Yorkshire, like Harrogate, it's only 30, 40 minutes. Praise the Lord. If you can travel all the way to go for holidays, etc., travel all over the place for shopping and amusement, you can travel to come to church once a week. Praise the Lord. So please, invite your friends, praise the Lord. Invite your family members, praise the Lord. Tell them about Decision Time. Now, our teaching is transformational, is strategic. The goal of our teaching is to open your eyes so you can see for yourself what we are dealing with, praise the Lord. Also, I'm on Sky Channel 590, that's Faith TV, every Sunday at 7 p.m., where you can watch our services, praise the Lord. You can feel the environment. You can hear the message. You can see the people. Praise the Lord. So 7 p.m. every Sunday on Sky Channel 590. That's Faith TV. You can watch us. That is not a live program. That is a pre-recorded program that we send to Faith TV. Praise the Lord. So please, in all this, our goal is to expose the devil. Are you getting the point? Our goal is to what? Expose the devil, number one. Our goal is to open your eyes, number two. Praise the Lord. Because you see, when your eyes become open and you can see reality, I'm telling you, you see, once your eyes become open and you can see the issues for yourself, you will not need anybody to tell you to read your Bible. Once your eyes become open, you will not need anybody to tell you to serve God. Once your eyes become open, you will not need anybody to tell you to walk in righteousness. I'm telling you the truth. Praise the Lord. Because you see, once your eyes becomes open, you see the reality as it is. You see, when you see something as it is, you don't need a second opinion. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? Praise the Lord. So don't downplay teaching. Don't downplay the word of God. Don't downplay revelation. This is very important. Because I know there is a company of people out there who simply are just looking for something. What you need to look for first is a revelation. You see, when something is revealed to you, it's no longer a mystery. When something is revealed to you, it becomes yours. You don't have to chase anybody for it. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the power. And also, we have an upcoming conference. Praise the Lord. We have invited our spiritual father, Bishop Francis Akwaba from Ghana. Praise the Lord. He is an international apostle. We have also invited him to come and minister to us. Praise the Lord. In Thy Kingdom Come 2017. Now, next Thursday, I will put the advert. Praise the Lord. Next Thursday, I'll put the advert out there. Praise the Lord. I'll put the flyer on the screen so you can see it. But if you want to join us for this conference, please, it's 28th, 29th, and 30th of this month. Praise the Lord. In the city of Leeds, in our church auditorium. Praise the Lord. If you are looking for healing, you are looking for deliverance, that bishop is an expert in that. Praise the Lord. So please, if you are sick or you are being demonically harassed, come 28th, 29th, 30th. Praise the Lord. So after this broadcast, if you want to come, just call me behind the scene. Praise the Lord. and then I will connect with you. God bless you. Before I share the word of God, I just want to pray with you. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the power. Yours is the glory. Yours is everything. Father, I thank you. I bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, open the eyes, the ears of the hearers that they may hear your word. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Today, I just want to speak to you about demons. Praise the Lord. Today, I just want to speak to you about demons. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the power. Yours is everything. Today, I just want to speak to you about demons. In Ephesians chapter 6, those four classes of spiritual entities, praise the Lord, they are different from demons. Praise the Lord. Now, demons, you cast them out. But those four classes of spiritual entities are ruling spirit. You don't cast those ones out. You wrestle with them. So today I want to focus on demons. Praise the Lord. The difference between those ones is that those ones, they hardly inhabit people. Praise the Lord. They rule externally. In exceptional occasions, they may come and dwell in somebody. Praise the Lord. But mostly, they like to rule territories. It may be a nation. It may be a district. It may be a town. It may be a city. It may be a particular tribe or a particular community of people. Praise the Lord. They exert their influence externally. But demons exert their influence internally. Praise the Lord. Now, there's a lot of questions there as to whether a Christian can be possessed or not. Now, I am not an expert in terminology. Praise the Lord. But from what I've seen experientially, you can have a Christian who speaks in tongues who has a demon. I've seen that many times. Praise the Lord. So the question as to whether it's demon possession, whether it's demonization or whatever it is, I don't know about that. But what I know is that I've seen tongue-speaking demons. I've seen tongue-speaking Christians with demons. Praise the Lord. Let's be careful as Christians. Praise the Lord. Let's go to Luke chapter 11. And in Luke chapter 11, we have got something very interesting here that I want to share with you. Thank you, Father. I'll read from verse 14, and then I'll quickly explain a few things. And then I'll open the line. Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 11, verse 14. That's what I'm reading. Luke 11, verse 14. And I want to remind you again, don't downplay the word of God. Don't underestimate the word of God. Praise the Lord. Everywhere they are doing teaching, every church where they open the Bible and teach, that's a good church. Praise the Lord. Not the church where they make a lot of noise. Praise the Lord. Not a church where they tell people all these folk laws. No. I'm talking about a place where they open the Bible and teach people and expose God and the devil to them so they can know the difference. Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 11, verse 14. Thank you, Jesus. And he was casting out a devil. Did you hear that? He said Jesus was doing what? He was casting out a devil. Principalities, we wrestle with the demons, we cast them out. Praise the Lord. And it was damp. Praise the Lord. And it came to pass, when the devil was gone out, the damp spake, and the people wondered. Praise the Lord. They didn't know the mystery behind why this person could not speak. Praise the Lord. But Jesus knew the mystery. Praise the Lord. But some of them said, he cast out devils through Beelzebub, the chief of the devils. And others tempting him, sought of him a sign from heaven. But he, knowing their thought, said unto them, every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and a house divided against a house falleth. Praise the Lord. So, if Satan also be divided against himself, how shall his kingdom stand? Because if ye say that I cast out devils through Beelzebub, praise the Lord. Here, the point Jesus is trying to make simple here. The devil is not divided against himself. Praise the Lord. And before I go, Lord, I would like to state this. Praise the Lord. There are Christians who visit the occult. Praise the Lord. Because they have a problem. Praise the Lord. I know Christians who visit other places because they have heard that, well, so and so place, if you go, you can get help. Praise the Lord. But please do understand something. That the devil is not divided. If there is a demon holding you, and you go to another place, praise the Lord, which is also using the power of the enemy, They may do certain things for you to give you what look like a temporary relief. But the point is that they are actually going to make your case worse. Because the agenda of the devil is one. The devil's motive and purpose is not divided. His purpose and motive is not to liberate anybody. The thief came to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Praise the Lord. Because I know tongue-speaking Christians who will send money to certain places. Praise the Lord. Don't think that if the devil is holding you, praise the Lord, and you're a Christian, the devil is holding you, you better seek the help of God to liberate you. But if you go to visit another place, don't think that the devil, if he has sent one agent to hold you, praise the Lord, if you go to another agency of his, that agency will liberate you. No, his purpose and goal is one. He's not divided in his motive. He's not divided in his thought. And he's not divided in his agenda. Praise the Lord. So all his agencies have got one goal. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He said, but if I, with the finger of God, cast out devils, no doubt the kingdom of God is come to you. Praise the Lord. The casting out of demons is a sign. Listen very carefully. The casting out of the demons is what? It's a sign. You see, it's a sign that the kingdom of God has come on this earth. You see, you don't see a lot of the casting out of demons. It was not something that was unveiled under the Old Testament. You see other miracles except this one. Praise the Lord. Why? Because in the New Testament, the kingdom of God literally has come. So the proof, see, if you attend a church where you see the man of God casting out a demon, it should communicate something to you. It should communicate what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 4, that the kingdom of God has come. Praise the Lord. So the casting out of demon is not something that we should play with. It's a sign that God's kingdom has literally come from heaven onto this earth. That God's reign, God's hand, God's government has come. That the arm of God has been stretched from heaven onto this earth. It's not to amuse. It's a serious thing in the sense that word. It's to communicate to us, the whole church, that God's government has come to replace the government of the devil on this earth. And the proof is that God can take out, praise the Lord, the government that the devil installed in a person and replace that with his government. I will skip that because that's not my focus. I'm just skimming through, praise the Lord. When I come to the key areas, I will focus on that. But I just want to touch this for you. That even for us men of God who are casting out demons, we have to understand that it's a proof that the kingdom of God has come. It's a proof that God is in the midst of his people. It's in the proof that God's eyes are open wide and that God is literally with us. He can see everything. So you don't cast out demon, praise the Lord, in the open, if you're a man of God, and then in private, you are doing something else. You are fooling yourself. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 21. When a strong man armed keepeth his palace, his goods are in peace. Praise the Lord. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor wherein he trusted and devised his spoils. He that is not with me is against me, and he that gathereth not scattereth. My goal here is not to explain these verses and to do the teachings on them. Praise the Lord. Because my goal is verse 24. But verse 21, verse 22, verse 23. There is a key thing there that I want to just mention to you, just mention in passing. That is armor, that word. A-R-M-O-U-R. You see, in spiritual warfare, you must understand that the devil has an armor. Praise the Lord. You must understand that. Unless you take from him his armor, you cannot disarm him. Neither can you buy him. Praise the Lord. Are you getting the point? The devil has got what? Amos, praise the Lord. One of his armor is unrighteousness. Are you getting? Another armor is lies and falsehood. Praise the Lord. That is what he uses to overcome people. Praise the Lord. If you want to know what are the armors of the devil, go to Ephesians chapter 6. Look at all the armors that have been listed there. The opposite of that armor is the one that the devil has. Somebody say, thank you, Lord. Our teaching is strategic. Our teaching is to open your eyes. So you, praise the Lord, can stand on your feet for yourself. The Bible says here, the devil is a strong man. The stronger person who come with Jesus, who is working through the believers, when he comes, he will take from him his armor. That's the key thing I want you to get. Praise the Lord. The devil has got armor. We also have got armor. Praise the Lord. From 24, 25, 26 is where I want to really focus on before I open the line. Praise the Lord. In verse 24, it says this. When the unclean spirit is come out of a man, praise the Lord. Demons, the generic term for all of them is unclean. There is nothing clean about them. They are corrupted spirits. They are polluted spirits. Praise the Lord. Now, some of them, there are different classes of them. Some of them can be the spirit of blindness, but they are still unclean spirit. They can be the spirit of insanity. They are unclean spirit. They can be the spirit of dumbness. They are unclean spirit. They can be the spirit of deafness. They are unclean spirit. They can be the spirit of lust, but they are unclean spirit. The generic term for demons is unclean. They are unclean spirit. There is nothing clean about them. I've seen them many times. They don't look nice at all. There's no beauty about them. Praise the Lord. If you see a demon appear very nice, that's a disguise. Praise the Lord. If you see them look so nice and beautiful, they have disguised. Praise the Lord. And if the Holy Spirit is to open your eyes, you will see that they have veiled themselves. Praise the Lord. So here, the number one thing is all demons are unclean spirit. There's nothing clean about them. Today, I will extend the teaching a little bit, so I will not open the line immediately. Praise the Lord. Now, when the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, praise the Lord. The number one thing about demons is they are unclean spirit. Number two, they are spirits. Spirits don't have bodies, but they are entities. They are beings. Praise the Lord. They don't have bodies. Number three, they can enter into people and stay there as long as possible. Listen. And if you're a Christian, if you give them access, they can stay in you. Praise the Lord. If you give them a license, they can come and stay there. Praise the Lord. They can come and stay where? There. So number one, they are unclean spirit. There's nothing clean about them. They are filthy spirit. Number two, they are spirits. They don't have body. Number three, they can come and stay in people. Praise the Lord. There is something about the human spirit that it has the capacity to accommodate a lot of spirit. See, the human spirit is so vast. The human spirit is so powerful. The human spirit is so strong that it can accommodate a lot of demons. That's a very strange thing. How powerful are we? That, you see, we can accommodate a lot of demons. It's a mystery. Praise the Lord. I will show you something here. In Mark chapter 5, praise the Lord, there was this spirit, praise the Lord. The Bible called it, Jesus said, unclean spirit. Also, Jesus mentioned unclean spirit. When Jesus asked the man, that's in Mark chapter 5, verse 9. When Jesus asked the man, what is your name? He said, my name is Legion, because we are many. Praise the Lord. Now, there was a lot of these demons inhabiting in one person. And I've seen it. I've cast out a lot of demons from people. Praise the Lord. And sometimes you can see series of them, many of them, in just one person. So do understand that these demons, their goal is to stay in men. They love that. If there is a place that they like to stay, it's in you. Praise the Lord. Number four, when they are cast out, in other words, when they are taken out, number four, he walked through dry places. So demons, they have the ability to move from places to places. They are not omnipresent. In other words, a demon cannot be in the same place at the same time. What they do is they move from one place to another. So they can be sent from one place to another. They can move. Now, this is the thing. They work like flies. They move, praise the Lord, by the power of the wind. I was casting out a demon from a lady, praise the Lord. And this demon was sent all the way from Pakistan. That's a strange thing. Now, the demon mentioned the name of the person who sent him. He mentioned the city where he was sent from. He mentioned the rituals, praise the Lord, that was performed before he was released. Demons don't need transport. They can walk from one continent to another. They move so quick, they move so fast because they don't have bodies. They are supernatural beings. So they have ability to walk from one place to another. They can send them from anywhere in the world to another place in the world. Are you getting the point? So they can move, they can walk. That's my fourth point. Fifth point, they move through dry places. In other words, they move through the desert. Praise the Lord. What are they doing? They are seeking rest. You see, there is something, when they are moving from place to place, they want a place where they can stay and get rest. Praise the Lord. Now, the point is this. When they are moving over all these dry places, why can't they stay there? No, those places are not comfortable for them. Praise the Lord. The place that they like to stay and rest is in men. So unless they get somebody to possess, they are not at rest. Listen very carefully. They move from dry places, but they cannot find rest in dry places. The only place they can find rest is in you. The only place they can rest and take rest, for that matter, the only place they are comfortable in is in men. Get this. So the number one agenda of every demon, praise the Lord, is to find somebody that they can enter. Thank you, Father. I'm exposing this so you can be careful. Praise the Lord. So that means they are looking for every opportunity to find a place of rest in you. Thank you, Jesus. And their rest become your restlessness. If you are listening to me right now, I want you to write this down. The resting place of the demons, which is you, their rest become your restlessness. And find none. Praise the Lord. When they go everywhere in the dry places, they can't find any. They try to enter other people to find rest. They can't. They make a decision. What decision do they make? They say, no, I want to come back. In other ways, the demons, this is the thing. Praise the Lord. They have ability to find you wherever they are. If they have been in you before, and maybe you were in England here, and we cast them out. Praise the Lord. And you relocated to Australia. Praise the Lord. If they could not find any other place, if they could not find any other person, enter and take their rest, they will come back. Now when they come back, they will look for you. So it doesn't matter where you will be at the time, they will be able to find you. That's quite interesting. So if you are in Manchester, praise the Lord, and now you move to Birmingham, they will come to Birmingham. I know what I'm talking about. There was a time I was working, I stayed in Leeds, but I was working in Rochdale. Praise the Lord. And I was dealing with a demonic case over the phone. After I dealt with the case, those demons I dealt with, they came to me in the place where I was working. Though I live in Leeds, at the time I cast the demon, I was in Rochdale in the night working. They didn't go to my physical house in Leeds, but they came to where I was working. Are you getting what I'm trying to put across? You see, we are dealing with a network, a demonically organized network. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. They know and they will find you. So they have ability to walk when they are cast out to look for rest. If they don't find it, they have ability to come back. They are intelligent beings. Praise the Lord. Now, the Bible says something. He said, I will return unto my house where I came from. Number one, to return, it means they will trace their steps back to where they were taken. The other thing is this. I don't know whether I'm on number six. He says, in other words, demons have the ability to talk. Now, you'll be thinking, oh, Pastor, what do you mean? Yes, I have heard them speak. I'm not just telling you something. They've come to my house, I've heard them speak. Praise the Lord. I've heard them all speak. When they came, they communicated with each other when they came to my house. I could see them. I could hear them. I heard their communication, what they came to do, praise the Lord, why they were there. And they communicated among themselves. My brothers and sisters, you see, this Bible is a real book. Let me tell you the truth. Those who say this word is not the word of God, they need prayers for their eyes to be opened. I saw them. They were two. They came to my house. The reason why they came at a particular time. The reason why they came at that particular time, when they came, what they saw, they communicated among themselves. They say, okay, let's go now, etc. Are you getting the point? They can talk. They have the ability to make speech, to express themselves. Praise the Lord. So they will return. They say, I will return to my house. This is very important. They did not say, I will return to that house. They say, I will return to my house. Praise the Lord. Where I came out from. You see, the demons, they look at we human beings house as their house. You know something? This earth, praise the Lord, was not created for the demons to stay in. Praise the Lord. Especially in this third heavens here, was not created for them. It was created for we human beings to live on comfortably. Praise the Lord. So only us can stay here comfortably. Them, they cannot. Praise the Lord. So we become like a house for them that they need to stay in order to be comfortable. That's the rest he's talking about. So they see you as their house. Not only do they see you as a house, they see you as their house. In other words, they think they have a right. See, I want to say something that I've heard some men of God say that there is a legal basis for demons to stay in people. Yes, but there is a more compelling legal reason why that legality can be canceled. That compelling reason is this. They are in the wrong domain. You see, they are in the wrong, in the first place, they are in the wrong place to start with. The fact that you open a door to them, that's, though it gives them some right, praise the Lord, that right can still be overridden. Why? Because they were not created to be in this domain. They have trespassed here. Let me give you an example. It's just like having a thief, praise the Lord, in your house. Praise the Lord. And the thief says, okay, because you opened your door down, that's why I entered. Yes, I opened my door down, but you still don't have the right to be here. So it does not matter whether you open a door or not. No demon was created to be staying on this earth, let alone to be staying in any man. Thank you, Father. Are you getting the point? Praise the Lord. So he said, my house. See, you are watching me right now. Every door that you have opened to the devil, he sees you as his or her property. Are you getting the point? He sees you as what? His or her property. Praise the Lord. He said, I will go back to my house where I came from. Praise the Lord. He said, if nobody will accept me anywhere, let me go back to where I came from. Are you getting the point? Praise the Lord. He said, my house. That house, praise the Lord, is you. The Bible describes us in many ways as houses for God. So the same way that God sees us, the devil also sees us the same way. Thank you, Jesus. You will not be a temple for demons. Please, you can open the line once I continue the teaching. Thank you, Father. He said, where I came out, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Please, you can open the lines now. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm still on verse 24. From whence I came out from, the lines are open. You can now call. Now, the Bible says, when he cometh, he find it swept and garnished. Demons, they have the ability to come back. This is very important. And we need to tell people this. That is why you have a lot of people doing one deliverance after another deliverance after another deliverance. Each deliverance you do, the next one become harder. And I'm going to explain this to you. Praise the Lord. Sometimes when you, after deliverance, we need to explain to you, praise the Lord, that if you allow the demons to come back again, your situation will be worse than before. Now, the Bible says, when he cometh, in other words, he is an, the demons are intelligent beings. They are able, see, even if you are twins, listen to this. Even if you are twins, they can never mistake you for your twin sister or brother. They know where they were. They know why they were there. They know when they were cast out. And when they come back, they know where they used to be. Praise the Lord. Are you getting the point? Thank you, Father. When he comes and find the place, praise the Lord, swept and garnished. When he comes back and find that there is no demon in the place. When he finds, in other words, when he comes back and enter into you, praise the Lord. He can know if there is another demon there or not. When he comes, he can be able to check within the spiritual environment in which he used to be. If there had been a change, he would know. Now, why did he say if it has been swept and guarded? When he was there, praise the Lord, he was messing the house, which is you. He left a lot of filth. Some people he left sicknesses. Some people he left poverty. Some people he left addiction. Some people he left field. So when he came back and saw that God, through the power of the Holy Spirit and his fire, has swept the whole floor and purged it and cleaned it, he knows. Praise the Lord. When they come back and they see the work that God has done by the power of the Spirit, they know. Are you getting what I'm trying to put across? Praise the Lord. The lights are open. They know. Thank you, Jesus. They know. They know. They know. They know. They know. Praise the Lord. You have to be careful. Praise the Lord. When the demons go, they come back. When they come back, they check where they used to be. They know the condition in which they left it. Praise the Lord. They know. When they come back, when the conditions have changed, they know. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to think about that. Praise the Lord. I was dealing with a particular case. Praise the Lord. Just want to give you an example. Where the demon left, we cast out the demon out of the person. Praise the Lord. The person went home. Praise the Lord. And he said, in the night, the demon came. Now, whilst I was casting out this demon, the demon spoke to me. And he said, if I go, I will come back again. And I said, you don't have a right to come. But somehow I suspected it could come, because this woman was not a Christian. And she was not ready to become a Christian. I don't want to mention which particular religion it belongs to. Praise the Lord. So I cast out this demon. This demon left. After 2 days, the woman came again and said, no, the demon has come back. I cast it out. Then the woman, after 3 days, the woman called me on the phone and said, the demon has come back. I said, no, the demon can't come back. He said, no, he came back. And I said, how did you know that the demon came back? He said, he came and he entered into me through my mouth. And I know that he came back. I was surprised. This woman is not a Christian. It belongs to another religion. Hello, caller, your name and where are you calling from?
Please, my name is Mary. I'm calling from Italy.
You're calling from Heathrow?
Italy, yes.
Italy, okay. Sister Mary.
Yes, good evening.
Yeah, what do you want the Lord to do for you?
Please, my son is now at the community, and he has been summoned to prison. They have given him 3 options. Either he comes home, or stay in the community for 2 years, or go to prison.
Okay.
And I'm praying that you will pray alongside with me so that the Lord will discharge and acquit him.
Okay. So what specifically do you want the Lord to do for you now?
For him to be discharged and acquitted.
You want to be discharged and acquitted.
Okay. I want the Lord's mercy to be upon him.
It's like, okay. God is a God of justice, but God always temper judgment with mercy. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we ask you to temper your mercy with judgment. Lord, we ask you to grant him divine mercy right now, wherever he is in that country, Italy. Lord, we ask you that you stretch forth your hand. You say you will show mercy to whom you will show mercy.
Amen.
Father, look upon the heart of the mother and grant the son mercy right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask, oh God, that you will acquit him in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will pardon him and give him another chance. Father, I thank you. I bless you. Every systematic attack against the mother, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I rebuke that attack in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I liberate the mother in the name of Jesus. I release you right now from every yoke and hold of the enemy. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. I command the Lord and his hand in the name of Jesus to grant you mercy in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for acquitting the Son in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you.
God now, bless you, God
bless. The point is this. This woman mentioned to me, he said, the demon came Praise the Lord. And entered into me. And I felt him. I felt the demon literally going into me. Praise the Lord. Hello, caller, your name and where are you calling from?
Oh, Pastor, we thank you for the good work. You are teaching us very good.
Oh, thank you,
my
Brother
George.
How are you, sir?
I'm okay, sir. I'm okay.
Wow.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Amen. Wow. Let me pray for you. Every time you listen, God will give you a special blessing.
Amen.
Because we are teaching to open the eyes of God's people. Father, in the name of Jesus, every door in George's life, Father, we close it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And we decree that your feet will be established upon these soils in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because God brought you here for the purpose and assignment. No demon, no devil from hell can discharge that assignment in the name of Jesus. May the Lord guard you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.
Oh, thank you. So here, the demons, they can come out. Praise the Lord. And they can come in. Many a times, if they are coming out, they come through the sole of the feet. Praise the Lord. Hello, caller, your name and where you are calling from.
My name is Mo.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
My name is Mo, but I'm calling from London.
Calling from London. Okay. What do you want the Lord to do for you?
I want to deliver me from every demonic attack.
You want the Lord to deliver you from?
Demonic attack.
Come again.
Demonic attack.
Okay. All right. Put your hand on your chest. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I rebuke every hand of the enemy over your life.
Amen.
I rebuke any familiar spirit.
Amen.
I rebuke any ancestral curse.
Amen.
I rebuke it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every familiar spirit trying to block doors in your life. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, I thank you. I rebuke it. I rebuke it. I rebuke it. There's something I'm saying. I rebuke it right now. I break that yoke of ancestral curse. Every spirit that is monitoring that curse, we command its power to be broken in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we release you completely. We release your other siblings. We release your family members in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Please, after the broadcast, you can call me. There's something I need to ask you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. After the broadcast, please call me. Thank you, Jesus. Now, listen to this. So, what I'm trying to say is, the demons, they can go out, they can come in. And a particular example I'm sharing, the woman said, it came back. I felt it, it entered into me. When it was going, I felt it, it went out of me. Praise the Lord. Now, when the demons come and find the place is swept and garnished and neat, they don't like it. When they come and they see the redemptive work, the renewal, the cleanliness that God has wrought in you, they don't like it. So see what, instead of staying alone, look at what they do. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Hello, caller, your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, good evening, sir.
Hello.
I'm calling from Newcastle. My name is Lena.
Okay. Sister Lena, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you, sir.
What do you want the Lord to do for you, Lena?
I would like you to pray for me, sir, for me and my daughter. We just want you to for divine intervention. Any evil hand against us.
Okay. Thank you, Jesus. You are hearing the teaching. The demons don't have any right over you. So agree with me right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit Sister Lena and the family unto the hands.
Amen.
Father, this family will not be a house to house the enemy, but there will be a house to house your glory, your spirit, and your power. I rebuke every work of darkness against their life. I rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I cancel every work of the enemy. Right now, receive it. I break every yoke over your life. I break every yoke now. I break it in the name of Jesus. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. Amen. And I decree that no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment, I condemn you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you. Now, then goeth he and take to him 7 other spirits more wicked than him. You see? My brothers and sisters, you see? The devil is not playing. His goal is one. To kill. He was there alone. Now that they cast him out, when he found the opportunity to regain you, praise the Lord. He did something. See, we are dealing with an intelligent beings. Just because you cannot see them does not mean they don't exist. The devil can reason. The devil is strategic. The devil is purposeful. His intent and motive is one. He never gets confused. We Christians get confused. Devil never gets confused about his goal. His goal is to destroy. And that is one. When that demon came back and find the place garnished and empty, he says, I will not stay here alone because next time they can cast me out easily. So he go and bring other demons who are also looking for a place of rest, but who are even more terrible, more powerful, more stronger than him, so that now they can help him, praise the Lord, to strengthen his grip over that house, over that so-called house of his. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Who would have thought that? Praise the Lord. I'll give you one example. You see, the demons, they work in collaboration. I was casting out a demon from somebody. These demons were two. Praise the Lord. There was one of the demons, I didn't have a legal right to cast that one. Because the woman belonged to a particular association whose demon was resident. And the woman made it clear to me that I belong to so-so and so. So that is it. But he said, I have a spirit which is saying, which is tormenting me. When I was trying to cast out, praise the Lord, the spirit that he gave me the right to cast, the other one which she did not give me the right was holding on to the one that he gave me the right to cast. Listen, there were two demons in the woman. One of them was there because of the type of worship she belonged to. Praise the Lord. And she said, I have no intention of changing my worship. So that spirit, I didn't have a right to cast it. But there was another spirit sent by a magician to torment her. Are you getting the point? The one I didn't have the right, because the woman didn't give me that, was holding on to the one he asked me to cast. I could literally see it. He was holding on. Praise the Lord. It was tug of war before I managed to decouple the two of them and cast the other one out. You see, the demons, they work in collaboration. Praise the Lord. The goal of the first one is this. He brought these 7 other more wicked, stronger, and terrible ones to come and help him strengthen the hold. Oh, Jesus. Are you getting the point? Don't give the devil a second chance. I said, don't give the devil what? A second chance. Praise the Lord. Because, see, there are a lot of people out there. If we cast the first one, he will come with 7. In other words, each one comes with 7 other ones. If we cast all the 8 out, praise the Lord, the next one will be 7 times, it will be 8 times what? 7. Demons that are coming. So each deliverance, each new deliverance become what? more difficult. Until now, you get to a place, you can't get anybody to cast the demons because now they become too much. So now, all you'll be doing is to jump in from place to place to place to place to place until finally you are finished. Praise the Lord. Are you getting what I'm trying to share with you about the demons? Praise the Lord. They are terrible beings. Be careful. Praise the Lord. Be what? Careful. Praise the Lord. Then goes he and take up with him seven other spirits, more wicked, more terrible than himself. He rather shared that house, praise the Lord, with other demons, praise the Lord, who will have dominance and control and influence and say over him in that house than to stay there alone. Father, we thank you. And they enter in and dwell there. All these seven. So now it's eight. Praise the Lord. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Are you hearing what I'm trying to put across? So, if first, if you had only one demon of diabetes and it was cast out, praise the Lord. But you open the door down again and the enemy comes in, now he will not come with diabetes alone. Praise the Lord. He will come with panic attack. He will come with heart disease. He will come with arthritis. He will come with depression. He will come with blindness. He will come with what? Seven other more wicked ones. Please, remember this. When we cast out a demon from you, do everything possible to make sure that you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. So that when the demons come back and they want to enter, they will encounter the stronger man that is the Holy Spirit. I thank you for watching this broadcast. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord increase you. May the Lord enlarge you. Also, please, if you want to partner with me financially, you want to partner with me in prayers, you want to partner with me by simply encouraging and exhorting me, please give me a call after this broadcast. Praise the Lord. And say, Pastor, I want to partner with you financially. I want to partner with you in prayer. Or I thank you for the message that you are sharing. God bless you. Until then, it's next Thursday for another segment of Decision Time. God bless you. Shalom.